Hello. Let's see if I can help you to join. Hello, Mike.
Hello.
Hello.
Hello, Alexa. Good morning, or good afternoon for you. Yeah,
Yes, good morning to you as well.
just dialing in via the phone, it's easier.
I'm sorry, what was that?
Oh, I just dialed in via my phone. That's easier. How are you doing today?
Awesome. I'm doing amazing. I'm actually in India right now, so it's quite hot.
Okay.
But yeah, how are you doing?
Very well. Yeah. I'm not in India. I'm in Amsterdam in our office. And yeah, we just had a nice barista workshop with one of my friends. So super nice morning.
Awesome. Well, cool to hear that we're calling in from all over the world.
Yeah.
And hopefully, a lot of the people watching are from around the world as well.
Exactly.
Well, great. Yeah, let's go ahead and kick things off. Just wanted to start off by saying hello to the BOAS family. My name is Alexa Smith, and I am currently a marketing intern for BOAS. And I've been the host of this Instagram live series where we've talked to thought leaders, entrepreneurs, experts, and activists with grand ideas of how to save lives while you live yours. And today I am joined by Mike Odenhoven, the founder and CEO of Sumting, which is a result-based platform for nature restoration. He also has a rich history of consulting with Deloitte, research with Philips, and two master's degrees. So, to get to know you a little bit beyond all of these accolades and experiences, I'll turn it over to you, Mike, to kind of introduce yourself and let us know how you got connected with BOAS.
Awesome, thank you. Yeah, so my background is, as you mentioned, two masters. So I did a study in design and a study in business administration, and that is kind of my sweet spot, so to say, in the interface between design and business. And then I started to work at Deloitte Digital, and basically in the venturing and innovation capabilities, so kind of building startups for the clients of Deloitte, so the large companies of this world. And that was mostly building digital platforms. So I really learned at Deloitte, working with all the wonderful people there, how to do this, and also kind of witness what the power of digital platforms can be, you know, like linking supply and demand, and creating kind of meaningful links between those things. And so, yeah, I built up this skill, I built up my network, and then I thought, okay, now I want to use that knowledge and power for something higher than just turning a profit, and kind of address what I believe is, and I think you believe the same, is the challenge of our generation to restore nature on our planet, and by doing so, fighting climate change. So that's when I started Sumting. I assembled a group of friends that wanted to come along for the adventure, that could do things that I can't, you know, like building a round and multidisciplinary team. And been on the adventure ever since.
Awesome. Yeah, that's a really beautiful story. And I always enjoy hearing how environmentalists kind of come into the work that they do. So it's really interesting to hear. One thing that I am personally curious about is what the meaning behind the name Sumting is.
Yeah, that's, well, it started from this feeling that I have, and that a lot of people with me have, that we wanted to do something for nature, you know, to really make a difference, more than just giving money and then you don't see the results. So that's really important. But in addition, we believe that with a digital platform, we can kind of mobilize the masses. So everyone can join in, everyone can do something. And then the sum of all those things will move mountains. And that's, yeah, we take some inspiration from nature there. So we see that the forces of change, you know, like rivers from raindrops, dunes from grains of sand, the forces of change are created by many small things coming together. So that's really the spirit in which we created the business, and which we are still building it today.
Awesome. Yeah, I mean, I personally just graduated with a degree in environmental science, and I'm pretty engrossed in the sustainability space. And I know that that's kind of a major topic of conversation, is whether individual action or more systemic change is really the answer to a lot of our environmental problems. So I'd like to hear a little bit more of your philosophy on that.
Yeah, well, I think both. So one can stimulate the other thing. And at least myself and a lot of our customers, they feel kind of, well, they want to do something, literally, all right? They want to give to take action. And I think if we mobilize a big group of people, if we create this global movement of nature restoration, then soon enough we can create systemic change by, you know, talking to governments, talking to the United Nations and the largest foundations in this space as well. So I think in time we can get there, but it starts with just you and me today. We can already take action. And then gradually we built the movement.
Mm. Right, yeah. And kind of with respect to the movement that's already going on, I mean, there's so many countless initiatives, from governmental action to corporations making commitments related to nature restoration. But one kind of flaw that I've noticed, and I'm assuming that Sumting is also noticed, is the lack of transparency and tracking when it comes to these things. So why is transparency so important for environmental actions?
Yeah, so that's really like the sweet spot. So we did a lot of research there, right, to dive deeper into this. And what we see is that, you know, like, people want to take action, people want to do something, but it's really important to see the results of your contribution. Right? Otherwise, it just sort of disappears and you never really know what happened. You've given some money and then you get a thank you note in your email and that's it, right? And then what happens? Did that money go into someone's pocket, or did it actually, I don't know, plant a tree or take some plastic out of the ocean? So that feeling that you can actually see what your money does and what difference you are making, that's what we're building this business for. And what you see is that what we hear from our customers as well is that it's very rewarding to get that feedback, so to see actually the results. And people understand that it takes a bit of time, and it doesn't happen instantly. If you buy a tree today, it can't go into the ground a second later, because someone has to actually go and do that. And that, yeah, that people understand that, and it contributes to the fact that they, yeah, believe this thing is actually happening. And then in addition, so, and then I have to get a bit technical, but if you look at some of the initiatives that are out there, and that are claiming that they are removing carbon from the atmosphere. But then if you take a closer look, it doesn't actually remove any carbon from the atmosphere, but it avoids the emission of carbon in the future. And so I think, and a lot of people with me, that humanity up until now has created a bit of a mess with carbon in the atmosphere, plastic in the ocean, deserts expanding quite rapidly, and biodiversity shrinking. It's not enough to just avoid further deterioration, right? We need to also clean up and reverse the path that we've been on for the last couple of years. But it's really cool to see that everywhere initiatives start popping up, also like your initiative at BOAS. This is super inspiring to see. And yeah, I think together we can really go after this problem, make it more transparent, more rewarding, and more universal to contribute to nature restoration.
Totally. I guess I was wondering if you could elaborate a little bit more on kind of the current carbon offsetting space, and which solutions for fighting climate change, desertification, pollution, or other kind of environmental initiatives do you find to be the most compelling, that's kind of in line with the work that Sumting does?
Yeah. So yeah, I think let me answer the second question first. So I think the initiatives, we are super proud of the partners that we are already working with. And I think what they have in common is a really kind of, a high level of integrity, so to say. So they really do what they say they do. And that's, of course, a fit with us, because we need the feedback to provide to our customers to show the trees that have actually been planted or the plastic that has been taken out of the ocean. And I think what they have in common is that they are open to this sort of mix of technology and people, right? So it's not just technology. We use technology to create the feedback loop, but there's also this human side. So we have a lot of good conversations with them and really start to think about how we can help them more. And so I think we are really just at the start of our partnerships with them. And in the future, as we build our platform and infrastructure, I'm very excited about the things that we could be doing as well, employing emerging technologies from third parties that we can bring to these partners, because we are a global platform, right? If everyone has to do that on their own, it's probably not feasible because of the cost and also the technology skills that are needed. But because we operate across the partners, we can start to do that. So that's really exciting.
Definitely. I also wanted at this time to just invite anyone viewing to drop any questions that they'd like to ask in the chat. So feel free to do that. But in the meantime, I was wondering if you have kind of a clear set of criteria that you use to vet potential partners that are actually like executing this on the grounds, boots on the grounds work. And if you have any like memorable conversations that come to mind with partnerships that you made early on in your journey.
Yeah, for sure. So we have a number of criteria that we select partners with. And let me highlight the three most important ones. So the first, I think, is permanence. So we want to make sure that, for example, if a tree is planted, that it has a good chance of survival, right? So you can throw a seed into a field and say a tree has been planted, but the chance that seed matures and actually becomes a tree that can store carbon, and perhaps even more important, becomes a part of a forest that can sustain itself, right? That's key. Otherwise, if you're just planting the same kind of trees, it won't mature. It won't be a permanent store of carbon. So we don't look for temporary fixes. We look for structural fixes. That's the first one. The second criteria has to do with additionality. So we want to be sure that if we work with partners, that once we put an order in for X amount of plastic or Y amount of soil revitalized, that would not have happened without our support, right? We want to make sure that we're not just giving money, but then otherwise that would have happened as well. Mm-hmm. And so we have contracts that cover that. And then the third one, which I mentioned already, is this integrity part. So on our side, the partners split out their prices. So what money is used for which causes. So how many are they paying good salaries to the people that are doing the work on the ground? Are they, how much is the material cost? How much are the permits to make sure that the land can be sustained? So that's really the third one. And then the last, it goes a bit without saying, but of course our level of feedback, so that we get a picture, timestamp, geostamp picture for each unit that is created, that is also something that is non-negotiable, right? If they don't want to work with us that way, then it's not a fit for us. But fortunately, most partners are very open to this way of working, because they see the problem or the challenge. They also want to show people as much as possible the work that they are doing. And so that's where we come in and have a nice kind of symbiosis. They do the work on the floor or on the ground, and we create that digital layer in the cloud, so to say, that creates the connection. So it's a nice collaboration.
Definitely. Yeah, that's wonderful to hear that there is a lot of enthusiasm for organizations and partners that are willing to actually execute some of this work as well. Have you noticed that there are any particular areas or kind of like divisions of nature restoration that have been the most successful so far?
Yeah, so at Sumting we define four areas. You mentioned them before, but one is taking carbon out of the atmosphere, and a very logical way to do that, planting trees. Oh, that's the first one. And the second one is taking plastic out of the ocean or out of rivers. And the third one is fighting desertification. So revitalizing soil that become too arid to host any nature biodiversity. And then the fourth one is restoring wildlife. So planting coral reefs, these kinds of things. And so what I see is that some customers have a really like personal passion. So for example, people that like scuba diving or like diving, they will gravitate towards these ocean based solutions, right? The coral reefs or the plastic. But more generally speaking, at the moment, it's still very much about the carbon. That's kind of the hot topic, right? That everyone's talking about. Everyone wants to be carbon neutral at least. But what we're saying is the challenge is bigger than just being carbon neutral, right? Carbon neutral is about, okay, you're a good citizen, you're compliant, you're for the last year. But as I just mentioned, like we also have this challenge to kind of clean up all the mess that humanity has made basically since the Industrial Revolution. And increasingly you see people that want to contribute to that as well. So I think to give a short answer, like a lot of people are still focused at carbon and trees, but working with us, they can start to see that the challenge is bigger and that they can also make nice contributions there.
Awesome. And then I was also kind of wondering if you could talk a little bit about your collaboration with BOAS.
Yeah, so BOAS, and perhaps you can tell a little bit more about BOAS as well, some of the BOAS mm-hmm. family watching, but BOAS has this very inspiring mission to be an e-commerce platform or a web shop, but then to kind of flow all the profits back into good causes, to charities. And that is slightly broader than nature restoration. There are other very important topics to be addressed, but our partnership focuses on that nature restoration side. So where we started with you and with the team is to kind of offset your CO2 emissions for the last quarter, and that will be an ongoing thing. Every quarter we have a contact with Vincent and then ensure that trees get planted and matured, and to ensure your carbon is taken out of the atmosphere. But we don't want to, we don't stop there, because the cool thing about BOAS is that customers can decide on which charity to support or which global goal to support. And that's where in the future we can build this integration, because we have the digital platform on our side, so that people that contribute to nature restoration via their BOAS purchase will also get feedback about, you know, what happened with their money. So essentially what I was talking about earlier, that you don't just give money and you don't see anything back, we will provide this one-to-one feedback to the customers, for example, for the tree that was planted or the piece of soil that was revitalized. Yeah, these kind of things. So that will become this sort of digital integration that makes it hopefully very transparent for the customers to see what they are contributing to with their purchase. But yeah, very happy to hear your thoughts, and also from people in the chat, if there's any additional thoughts about how we could make that partnership even cooler or more rewarding.
Definitely. I mean, it definitely, from my perspective, is our values are completely aligned. On the end of BOAS, we're very passionate about transparency, and on our website, you'll find releases of kind of our expenses and our carbon footprints. So I think we're definitely on the same wave there, and I'm really glad that we're able to partner together.
Cool, yeah.
Yeah, let's see. One other thing, I'm not seeing any additional questions in the chat right now, but one kind of final question that I was curious about was, what do you see as the future of Sumting, and what are the next steps for you?
Yeah. Yeah, so the future of Sumting is very exciting, and it has to do with, you know, all the possibilities that these digital platforms, digital integration layers can provide. So what we are already seeing is that, you know, we have our own channels now as Sumting, right? We have our web shop, we have our subscriptions, we allow businesses to create, like BOAS has done, you know, offsetting their impact, and then have a nice page also on our website. But that's all in our court still. The really cool stuff starts to happen when we move outside of our channels and into the channels of, yeah, partners that we work with, like the example I just gave with BOAS. But there could be hundreds of those kind of use cases, right? And we have a lot of cool ideas about that. So you could see into your loyalty apps, with whether it's with travel or with sports or whatever vertical that you're in, the checkouts. So if you, yeah, like the BOAS case, but that could be the same if you book a hotel night somewhere, and it could even be event based. So every time X happens, we plant a tree. Every time Why happens, we take some plastic out of the ocean, right? And that could be businesses that contribute to it in that way, creating this sort of very easy to enter into partnership, because the growth comes from each transaction. So it's not a one-off upfront transaction, but it actually scales as our partners scale. So that is one really interesting element. And then the other thing is what I mentioned before, is like the powering technology. So there are so many cool startups out there that are doing really inspiring things with satellite imagery, drone footage, internet connected sensors, or time-lapse cameras, these kind of things. And that is really where we see major investment coming in the future, to make it even more transparent, even more rewarding to contribute to nature restoration.
Wow, that is incredibly exciting. I cannot wait to follow along your journey. I think that's really everything that I wanted to ask you directly. Is there anything else you'd like to share about, or any asks from the BOAS community? Anything else on your mind that you'd like to talk about?
No, well, I want to thank you for for your time and your, I think this was a very lovely conversation and we should do this more often.
Yes, definitely.
And yeah, overall, I think, look, if there are people out there that want to help in this challenge, right, the challenge to restore nature, then obviously this is a reach out to you. So if you have a startup that is working on these things, either in emerging tech or you're planting trees, taking plastic out of the ocean, definitely reach out. If you have a business and you want to contribute to this challenge, then also reach out and we can help you and set up a very nice program for you. And finally, even if you're just a person like you and me, you can literally contribute today with just something as simple as planting a tree. As I mentioned before, it's a sum of things that count. So even if we all do something very little by ourselves, together we can move mountains. So that's really what I wanted to share with the community.
Beautifully said, yes. And take advantage of the communities that we each bring. Feel free to follow both of our accounts on social media if you don't already. And either of us would be happy to respond and connect you with, this mission. We're really all in this together, as you said. So thank you again, Mike, for joining me today. This will go up on our YouTube channel and LinkedIn as well. Thank you again. And hopefully we can talk again soon.
Yes, I look forward to to collaborating on this wonderful mission with you together in the future.
Awesome. All right. Goodbye, everyone.
Bye-bye.
Have a good evening. Bye.